Welcome in the last part of step-by-step video. In this video I'm going to finish the Zulu warrior. Yeah, finally. I start with the necklace. The necklace is made by bones, and for bones the start color or the base color is beige or cream. I paint one or two thin layers. The color on my palette is an old citadel color called bleached bone, but as I have mentioned, you can use similar tone of this color. Next step is only about washes. My favorite washes are from Army Painter Company, and the names are Strong Tone, which is brown, and Dark Tone, which is black. The first wash layer is only black. I cover all parts of the necklace, and I don't dilute the wash this time. Second wash layer is a mix of black and brown tone, and again no dilute, and cover all parts of the necklace, especially around each bone. As you can see, the bones start to look used. I don't like bleached bones from the sun. and again a mix of black and brown wash, but now only on some parts of each bone and around each bone with gold outline, and it helps me separate the necklace from the animal fur under it. I use a hair dryer for faster drying of each layer. Let's go back to the beige color, which I've used for the base color. This time I add a water to the color and start paint the bones. But I don't cover the bones completely. I only paint some parts of the bone that are more bleached. Because the color is diluted, I have under control the contrast of each bleached place. Black color for hair and the thing on the top of the head. I often use acrylic colors for small parts on the figure or bust. One of them is a group of feathers. I'm going to paint them red. Colors on my palette are black, cadmium red, and flat red. I start with the cadmium and I try to use diluted color. The color doesn't cover the primer at all, but it helps me to achieve a good result. I paint only lines, one by one, and overlay each layer. The paint is more smooth and lines represent the feather. The darker tone in the middle and lighter, more reddish, on the edges. the first feather is done. Let's go finish the others. And the group of feathers is finished. I used the same technique for the main feather of the front of the headband. My colors are black, white, and English uniform. And again, darker tone in the middle and lighter tone on the edges. Only lines one by one and diluted color. I have used the same animal fur around the head and of course the same color scheme, technique, spots and circles. Well, the bust is finished and we can start a new project. This time it will be a figure. Thank you very much for watching and we see you soon.